What are like the pros and cons?
As a husband and wife, you know, she'll nag the shit out of me. Snag the cons shit the out of only me. I am, let me speak. Like this, she doesn't let me speak at home. She doesn't let me speak. I don't care about the history. History of Babar, kaun tha, mereko kya karna hai, yaar?
I'll say mine and then Rohit will say his. Which is why it's Mr. and Mrs. Roy together.
I'm giving you tips not for travel, for marriage.
This is quite an informative podcast.
No, so it depends on which partner you want to travel with.
Chal bhai, bol raha hai ki aise time pass kar rahe hain. Chal. Bande bhai.
Welcome to In Conversation with Mr. and Mrs. Roy. Now we have Mr. Rohit Roy and Mrs. Manasi Joshi Roy. Unbelievable actors, but more than that, even passionate travelers. Now, I saw your show about AlUla. I'm in love with the videos. They're unbelievable. Like, I'm a fan. I saw it and I was blown away. How did you like AlUla? Because it seemed like you guys were having a great time.
AlUla was like surreal. That's the only word. Remember? Yeah. That's a word I kept repeating every time we were, you know, visiting any of the places in AlUla. Because the topography, the landscape, it just feels like you're... Like, I've never seen anything quite like that in my life. And we've traveled a bit.
You know what I thought when we landed and then we started driving towards where we were living? So if I give you a parallel, what if I was to take you and drop you into the world of Avatar?
Really?
I take you from India, I put you on a plane, and I drop you into the world of Avatar, and you're looking around and you've never seen that in your life.
Yeah.
Not in cinema, not on television, not in documentaries. AlUla is a place which seems, it's magical. Because like she said, the topography is very, very different. And the entire thing is like a huge set which has been built. And everything about it is so unique. That there, you know, this parallel about Avatar is the only parallel I can make. Because I haven't seen, like she said, we've traveled a lot. We've gone to exotic places. All right. But AlUla is a once in a lifetime experience.
Because those sandstone formations, those
amazing,
rocks.
Yeah. What are that thing that we saw? That elephant rock? No.
Yeah, that was one of them. Was
one
elephant
of those
rock.
I saw these really tall rocks that were there. What was that also?
So that one of them, that was Hegra. Hegra is actually a UNESCO site now. And so basically, like, you know, how you have the pyramids. This was the thing that they would build for the dead. They were like tombs.
They were tombs.
They were tombs.
So the bigger the tomb, the richer the gentleman.
Yeah.
No, and so, its pedigree was decided by how many doors it had, how tall or how big it was.
Yeah. People are just getting aware of this place.
But would you say now, for example, when I travel for work, I travel super luxury. Your show is also super luxury. Really nice, you know.
You must be a star, bro.
No.
We have to struggle, yeah.
It's super nice. You have such beautiful hotels, you know. And, you know, but like when I'm traveling, for example, I travel super stripped down. Like I get into the city or I get into the culture and I do that, you know. Tell me about that experience because it looked really luxurious as a place. Would you define it like a luxurious place or would you define it like a backpack?
I would say it's the lux of all lux experiences. To begin with, the moment we went there, we couldn't understand where the hotel was because spread over what? I don't know, hundreds of acres.
Yeah.
And the good thing about banyan tree at AlUla was that each villa was a well-appointed and really at a distance from the other one. So it seemed like you're the only one in the middle of it. Of course, it's like a desert. But different kind of a desert made of sandstone. It's all red and then you could see the yellow sand. And they have put in a thing called, it was a glass pyramid in the middle of all that which reflected the entire AlUla, which was bang opposite our villa. So I can't explain to you in words unless you go there, unless you see it for yourself. It's almost impossible to put in words.
You also did another show, Mr. and Mrs. Roy, on the Maharajas Express. Tell us about that. What was that all about?
That was actually, that was so cool. That was really, really cool because...
She's a technical director. She'll tell you from where we went to where, from where and where. So that, I think you should do it.
So yeah, we basically did all of Rajasthan, like the major, you know, cities in Rajasthan and also ended with Delhi and Agra. And it's pure luxury. It's like, you know, you imagine this is how the Maharajas obviously traveled because you see each car was so well appointed. There were two bars, two restaurants, every room was like stunning. They had suites also, and they had deluxe rooms. So there was like a variety of, you know, different kinds of rooms depending on what you are wanting to spend. So you can go all the way and get the suite, which is like this living room and two bedrooms. And, you know, it's just amazing. And the bathrooms, because everybody asked me, oh, you went on a train. How was the bathroom? Like, how was the bathroom?
I mean, I would ask that
it
too.
It had forest
that?
Essential, you know, this toiletries.
This so is exactly like answer. The Maharajas probably travel when they wanted to go from one place to the other.
Yeah.
So imagine a Maharaja traveling. I mean, you don't ask him how the damn bathroom was, right?
It was
My favorite part was the bar.
Yeah.
Really?
It was such an awesome bar. In the evening, everybody on the train would come and sit in the two bars, Prosecco was flowing from morning to evening, okay?
Yes.
Non-stop. And
flowing in.
I would know, yeah. Ebbing in and out. And somehow, so at breakfast, you would have your first Prosecco, then you'd go out, you come back, have lunch, etc. What really got to me was the way the food was laid out.
Yeah.
If you've seen the videos of the Maharaja Express, if you haven't, please watch it. Even the cutlery, everything was like top notch. And, you know, it seems like I'm actually advertising them. I'm not. I just want to share my love and my experience, because that's what we like to do.
Yeah.
You know, we're actors first, but I think a very close second is that we are avid travelers.
Since you mentioned that, I want to know from you, was this always like a passion that you wanted to do? And where did the idea of Mr. and Mrs. Roy come?
Actually, the idea has been in the making for a very long time.
So to answer your first bit, both Manasi and me are very different in many ways. But our love for travel is absolutely on point when it comes to anywhere. And it's not like we have to go all of India. Mm. We travel in India, we travel abroad. We travel to as many different countries. And this is something, so everybody asks, what's on your bucket list? Our bucket list is every place in the world. You know, we want to go to as many countries, see as many cultures, try as many cuisines as we can.
Have you kept a count?
Of course, we've kept. I've kept her. She has kept a count in her mind. She can give you dates.
It's not. I'm like wanting to, you know, make it grow. Hmm. So I think maybe 25 now. That's not enough.
That's not enough.
That's
I
not
feel
enough.
You know, the only thing you can do with life is travel.
Yeah, that's true.
And I was going to ask the second bit of your question. Mr. and Mrs. Roy is a concept which we came up 15 years back or more than that.
Yeah, more than that.
Approximately 15 to 20 years back. And that's something which we've been wanting to do forever. Because A, it satisfies our lust for travel.
Mm.
And B, we end up making a little bit of money.
And it gives us a chance to share this with everyone. I love it.
Yeah.
Like, we have our own beautiful travel videos.
Yeah.
So it's like perfect.
It's also travel with like super luxury, right?
Yeah.
So like, what do you think you must have spent on like the AlUla trip for people who are planning to go to AlUla?
Let me take that question. Usually she would answer that question because, you know, obviously she's the finance minister as well. Well, be honest. Yes, it was very expensive. I think a trip like this for two people, considering everything, would cost you around 15 to 20 lakhs. Fortunately for us, we were hosting it for Travelxp. So we were taken care of. But I want to add one thing here. It's not about the expense. It's about the experience. And today, every youngster wants to invest in the experience, because that's something that it's a memory of a lifetime. You can buy a car in 4 days. The fascination for the car or a watch will go away. I can guarantee you that. Okay? And she'll underwrite it. But an experience like AlUla, I think, is priceless. So if you ask me what it costs, 15 lakhs, but it's priceless.
What about the Maharaja Express?
The Maharaja Express, if I remember, was around 13 to 15 lakhs, something like that.
Wow. Now, I have to ask you very importantly.
He's wondering, ye do trip ek saal mein kaise kar liya?
I'm like, this is my 10-year budget, you know. But just, I wanted to ask you, you know, was it worth every penny?
Totally.
Yeah?
Completely.
Both the trips?
When I say priceless, that means, you don't even look at the tag.
You know, we've had so many people ask us about these trips after they saw our videos. Yeah, both Maharaja Express and AlUla. And I would always tell people, you know what, that experience was worth it. Of course, we were hosting it for Travelxp. But the point is, would I go and do this on
100%.
My own? Yes, I would.
100%.
So that should tell you how.
So let me give you a parallel again. When we travel to any part of the world, the expense is exactly the same.
Yeah.
But this kind of an experience, I don't think we've had anywhere.
What is your favorite story from this trip?
From AlUla?
Yeah, from AlUla.
For me, the fun part of it, everything was fun. But I think when we went to those hot air balloons.
The hot air balloon ride, yeah.
Two of them actually. The hot air balloon experience was outstanding because you saw AlUla from a different perspective completely. All those huge tombs seemed so tiny when you were up there in the air. So
and
one
early
was
in the
that.
Morning, it early was just, in the morning, it was yeah. magical, yeah.
Yeah, it was sunrise. Like 5 o'clock in the morning. Yeah.
We went
so it's called
sunrise.
The sunrise ride.
Yeah.
And the second part was for me, the helicopter ride.
Yeah.
You cannot beat it. So imagine this, red sandstone everywhere. We almost dressed similar.
Yeah.
Kale mein
the,
black helicopter and going through. So I'm thinking like a filmmaker, but going through all the ruins of AlUla. And it was divine. I don't know what was her memorable moment.
No, for me too. The hot air balloon ride for sure. Because people go to Cappadocia typically, you know, when you talk about hot air balloon rides, Cappadocia, Turkey comes to mind.
Yeah.
And of course, that looks lovely. And but this, I would say, is also a great experience and definitely worth trying. See, everything is different. Mm. But I would say that if you go to AlUla, definitely do this.
Wow. Was it better than Cappadocia? Better than
You know, I'd say that Cappadocia has been in existence for a long, long time. AlUla is fledgling territory, so everything is being set up while we speak. But if I had to compare the experiences, it's at par. And let me tell you one thing. Now, I might be saying much, but I think in the next 10 years, this will be the place where people seek out to go for all these experiences. And this is a very small part of AlUla. This is something that they started क्योंकि ये है एक model है और वहाँ का topography ऐसा है कि आप जा सकते हो hot air balloon में लेकिन इसके अलावा इतने सारे experiences वहाँ होने वाले हैं I think AlUla people should hire me for being their marketing manager here but honestly it's superb
you have heard this here first by the in the next 10 years AlUla
I'm telling you
will
I'm willing
be
to put my
one
money
of the hottest
on
destinations for oh, sure yeah.
Hottest.
Doesn't
hottest. Yeah. No. Apparently, the weather is very good depending on what time of the year you go. And though we went when it was hot-ish,
yeah, but it, is not
it was okay.
So hot.
It didn't matter. You
no, it didn't matter.
You time it. You go when the sun's you know low. Don't go between 12 to 3 when it's at the highest.
Because you're more of the planner now between the
yeah.
two of you. Have you planned your next few trips already?
My gosh, we are always planning and
constantly
planning. But these days, currently, you know, most of our trips take us to the US.
So, you have to tell him why, otherwise he'll
think
why.
Because our daughter studies in the US. So since the last 3 years, our trips, like we kind of, you know, gravitate towards the US.
That becomes so luxe that we are left with not much luxe to travel anywhere else.
But no, we have a big list of, like Rohit said, the wish is to travel in to every country possible, you know, in this lifetime, as many as I can do.
So if you had to make a bucket list of the next 5 destinations that you really want to go to, what would those be?
I'll say mine and then Rohit will say his. Okay, so mine is...
Or maybe he just has to agree to wherever you want to go.
He's allowed to have his own bucket list.
No, in terms of travels, he doesn't. No, maybe a little bit.
So mine is Alaska for sure. Machu Picchu.
Mm-hmm.
Then I really want to do the south of France. Not done that. I want to do Mexico. And I also want to go to Europe. I want to go to the smaller countries in Europe, which I've not seen still. Like, you know, we've seen the bigger ones, but I want to go to the smaller countries.
Beautiful.
So our bucket list, obviously top of the list for me is the Alaskan cruise.
Yeah, we both want to really
That's something that I really want to do and we are planning to do it next year. The second is Machu Picchu because she was very keen to go there and then I read The Secret. And I want to go there too, just to experience that vibration. What is it?
Yeah.
My third on my bucket list is I want to do Italy in a way that I've not done. I want to go to Lake Como, etc. and that whole thing. And I want to rent one of the small... you've done your bucket list, no?
Huh? No,
see,
I'm telling you
this
where
is
you
a subtle way of telling me what my bucket list is. So I want to rent one of the small Fiats and go... Amalfi Coast.
Yeah,
man, you're just as tall as me. How are you going to fit in that?
No, no, we will fit. You know, if you want to travel, you have to make certain concessions. You have to make it. So that's my third. My fourth, I really want to go is I do a bike ride in Australia and New Zealand.
Mm.
I haven't been to New Zealand ever, which is very strange because that's closer to us than any other place. And the fifth would be North
Far East.
Far East, yeah. I want to take her to Russia because I went to Russia and it was spectacular.
Yeah, I'm
maybe not currently, but in good time.
Soon.
We didn't tell him what we really wanted to tell him.
Which?
Our joint bucket list, there's one which we want to do is go back to Saudi Arabia and maybe also to AlUla because our daughter didn't go.
Okay.
And she was killing us.
Yeah, she was...
So the joint on our bucket list, which we are going to do for sure, is go back to South.
Yeah,
India.
She was livid that we got to see this place.
Before I move on to the next question, I just wanted to know, when you showed her the show, what was her reaction?
Oh my God.
She was like, why did you guys go without me?
She didn't say how good or bad it was. She said, how could you know?
Yeah, how dare.
How dare you go to this place without me? Because she loves travel as much as we do.
Yeah.
She's something, you know, also because from the time she was under a year, she was, I think, 11 months when she started traveling. We took her to America when she was 11 months. And since then, every year, we tried to take her somewhere. So there are times when she doesn't even remember she's gone to Scotland, or she remembers, but she has a vague memory. Hopefully, we will try and continue doing that even now as she grows up.
You know, one of my favorite experiences that I've seen so much about is to do one of these igloos in Finland.
She
wanted to do the Northern Lights.
Yeah. How could I forget? That's also
See,
one
that's
of
what
my...
She's ended up. We want to go everywhere.
Yeah, we want to go everywhere.
But like, they have these stunning hotels on the cliffs. You know, that's something.
They look stunning.
What is that dream? Like if everything is possible, what is on top of that list? Like an experience.
So I would say that now that you reminded me of this, the Alaskan cruise and this Northern Lights first. Like these two are top of my list.
Now that
you've
reminded us. Yes.
Then the rest of it. Then to like there is the whole world to see, right?
I think now I want to go there first before I go to Alaskan cruise. Bhul gaya tha yaar.
But in AlUla as well, you also driven a vintage Range Rover.
Yeah, he loved it.
What was that all about?
If you've seen the video, then you saw how hot I was looking in front of the Range Rover.
It was very hot, so that's why.
It was very cool and it was very hot, and I love cars like every other boy, I was going to say man. And that was also one of the experiences that I really enjoyed. And again, it all boils down to where we were. It's like going into a new world, into a different world. You're not on Earth. You know, so if I take you somewhere else, I say, okay, ja, ghoom ke.
And Rohit loves going on these cars, right? So he did this in AlUla, and you also rode one of those vintage cars when we went on the Maharajas Express, right?
I drove a vintage car in Udaipur.
I think, yes. There was like this whole one of these palaces where they had all these vintage cars.
It was a 1940 Buick, open top, obviously. It belonged to the Maharaja at one point. And so actually, I have to thank Travelxp for giving me these experiences.
Yeah.
You know?
You mentioned, you know, that you like, that you want to drive a vintage Fiat in Italy. Mm-hmm. You drove a vintage Range Rover in Saudi Arabia, in AlUla. And you drove another vintage car in Udaipur. So, now, do you have any specific country and any specific vintage car that you want to match?
Yes. I also want to go to the Italian Grand Prix roads. I believe they let you drive a vintage Ferrari.
And oh, they do?
Yeah, there's a company, and it's one of the original cars that was used in the Mont 4 of the 70s. And they let you drive that. And I think there's a company that runs that. So that's not something that I'm very passionate about. But if I do go there and I get a chance, I'll let you know. I will do it.
Which is your favorite car? Like, what is your dream car? Which is the one that you want to buy?
So my name is Rohit Roy, RR. I obviously want to buy the Rolls Royce, and I will buy the Rolls Royce, and I want to buy the black patch Cullinan. For sure. I'm just waiting to make a little more money from Travelxp. and the moment they pay me, I'll buy the black. But no, that's been a dream since I was in school. When I was in school, we could only see pictures in foreign magazines. Very rare to see a Rolls Royce image. And then I saw the ad, the Rolls Royce commercial. So there's this guy who comes in to buy a Rolls Royce, and he takes the Rolls Royce for a drive and all that. And he comes back into the showroom and he says, can you lift the hood? Can I see it? And they lift the hood and there's nothing. There's no engine. He said, I just went for a drive. So the guy looks at him and says, sir, it's a Rolls Royce. It runs on reputation. Wrong term, you've been standing. Since that day, I wanted to buy a Rolls Royce, and I will.
Wow, that's like a quote I would tattoo on myself.
Yeah, it runs on reputation, man.
But because she's the planner, and I know the amount of customization a Rolls Royce would do, you know, do you get to decide the interiors?
Yeah, I think I should. Yeah, thanks for telling me that. Now
no,
I know.
No, I think she will decide how much I can spend on the interiors, but I will decide what interiors I want. But she'll be the one to decide where you should stop.
So, before, you know, we're in, you know, towards the second half of this now, and I just wanted to, like, what was your first trip that you took? What was that like? First trip ever.
First trip ever.
Quite interesting.
For the two of us.
Yeah. Yeah, you can consider that as the first
trip. Yeah, that was our first trip to the US, actually, when we both were dating. And we had gone to the US and we were in New York. We were in, you know, we went actually to Florida together and went to Disneyland for the first time. And it was so much fun. That whole Disney trip was the best.
And you know, even then, we didn't have so much money.
Yeah, that time it was not luck.
We didn't have so much money.
I had gone for work and he had come to meet me.
Yeah, we got lucky that she was already there for work. She was doing shows there with her dad. And I was an out of work actor. So I had nothing to do. So my uncle bought my ticket and I went to meet her there.
Yeah.
And then I stayed with them, you know, wherever they put me up. So. But it was like I said, it doesn't matter how rich you are or how poor you are. It's the experience. And if that experience was, according to me, one of the best.
Yeah. It's been how many years? 1994.
Wow. So it's been 30 years now. And I think I remember it like yesterday. I also remember where we ate.
Yeah.
Red Lobster.
The Red Lobster. That time we thought, oh, wow, we are at the Red Lobster.
Yeah.
And, you know, but now we realize that that was actually just a small chain.
So who decided to make these plans first? Because I want to get to know, because I feel right now you're in a phase where you're not messing around with her planning at this point.
No, I've never done
it. Never does.
I mean, even the first America trip was obviously the idea had to come from her, you know. So I think even now it's more like, you know, she knows where we should go. But I do the peripherals, like I'll do the hotels and I'll try.
I'll let him book the car.
Book the cars. And then we'll kind of jointly do the tickets and all of that. Even the planning of it is interesting for us. It's so much fun. You do stuff together. I mean, that's where the trip starts from.
So, you know, like, let me tell you this. Like, my friends call me Google because according to them, I kind of will give them answers to everything. And especially when it comes to travel, I'm like, really, like, if I'm going to go to a place, so though we were going to AlUla with, you know, Travelxp and our experiences are more or less kind of charted out, but I will still read up on it.
Yeah.
I will still find out what we are doing and I will call up, you know, my director and find out, okay, you know, what's the plan? What are we doing tomorrow? What's our itinerary? Where are we going? I just love to research and I especially love to research the history, the culture, and AlUla has a, you know, a 2000-year-old history and the culture, and it's really rich. So it's not just about the luxury, you're also imbibing, you know, all of the other things that are part of it.
Apart from the tombs, did they tell you any other stories of the place that you'd like to
tell? So we went to this old town, which is really beautiful. They preserved it, which I love the fact, remember?
Yeah,
it's so beautiful that they preserved. There is a certain section of that old town where those buildings are the way they were. What they did is very clever. They made those, the people who were the inhabitants of those old homes move into other homes, and then these homes became like museums.
Oh, that's lovely.
And in fact, I believe there's one hotel which is going to come up in Old Town, which is going to be in one of those old houses, and it's going to have no electricity. Everything's going to be only lit by lamps. And it's going to be a very, you know, luxurious experience, but of a different kind. So that was one very fascinating thing. Then we also found out when we saw all these sandstone, you know, these rock formations, which like Rohit said, there was one elephant and there was these different, you know, huge rocks. So we said, okay, how did this happen? So we started reading about it and we found out it was all underwater once upon a time.
That's how
sandstones have been created. So every formation has been created over thousands of years. And today it's a desert, but once upon a time, it was under the sea.
I feel travel that way, you know, really like changes you as a person.
Yeah.
Like I discovered traveling solo sometime around 2017 when I went to Spain for the first time. Because everybody saw Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara and decided to go and decided to jump out of a plane. So I decided to go there and it was great because I figured out solo travel was my thing. Like it was just, you know, what would you like to tell everyone who's watching this about just travel in general? Like, you know, just like how important is it, you know?
Just taking a cue of what you said, you know, I try to be brave and I try planning solo travel because I want to do it. One part of me wants to do the solo travel. So wherever I'm going for work, I stay back for 3-4 days and I want to do stuff solo. But I've realized that I can't function without him.
Which is why we are on a show called Mr. and Mrs. Roy.
It's not Mr. Roy.
It's Mr. and Mrs. Roy together.
And I tried to do this Mr. Roy thing. In fact, I have a lot of things that I've worked out in my mind and paper that I want to do a bike ride here, there.
No, then Mr. Roy calls me up. Okay, listen, I am going to be here. Can you research what I should do?
I was in Dubai,
Then I have to give him an itinerary. Okay, maybe you should do this.
And it was an amazing hotel. And this is after I'd finished my work. And I was there for 2 more days. And I called her. I said, listen, I'm eating in a Michelin star French restaurant. But without you, it just feels not complete.
Oh.
So
therefore, Mr. and Mrs. Roy like to travel luxury because, you know, one doesn't feel complete.
Because it's wasted on me. Alone, it's wasted on me. But I'm still try and travel solo. The only thing is I can't do a backpacker, but I will still want to travel solo at some point.
That's amazing. Because, you know, now you guys travel as partners.
Right.
Tell me, what are the things that people who travel, because I'm still trying to figure out if I can travel with a partner. I don't know if I'm there yet.
Oh, you love it.
That's what I'm coming to.
I think it's fun.
What are like the pros and cons?
Cons though is like any normal con of a husband and a wife. Those cons remain.
No, so it depends on which partner you want to travel with.
That's a smart answer.
With as a husband and wife, she'll nag the shit out of me.
The cons are the same. Only it's in a foreign country.
Like what research she said. Now I'm the exact opposite. I don't care about the history. History of Babar kon tha, mereko kya karna hai yaar. Mereko kya lena dena hai?
Started caring about the history. That's why
Speak like this. She doesn't let me speak at home. She doesn't let me speak. So when there is a script and my director says, "Ke ma'am, aapko ye bolna hai, sir ko ye bolna hai," then is the only time I get to put 2 lines inside. But to answer your question, it's the best thing to travel with somebody, with a partner. Doesn't necessarily need to be a wife. It could be your best friend. Yeah. It could be basically you need somebody there with you to banter, to jam, to enjoy what you're doing. Solo travel is also great, but after an experience of 30 years of traveling, I'd say traveling with somebody who's equally passionate about travel is much better.
Like I do a lot of girls trips and I really enjoy my girls trips, you know, with my bunch of friends. So.
Wow, I was talking about traveling with her and she's saying, I go with a bunch of my girls, you know, I enjoy.
So what I'm trying to say is travel is so wonderful. And travel, I think, is so essential for us because like they say, it broadens your horizons in every way. So travel solo, travel with friends, travel with your husband, but just travel.
Chal, you and me will travel. We'll go for a show. We'll shoot ourselves and come.
Done.
Okay. Super.
Behind all those slow motion shots and, you know, high end vintage Range Rovers and all, this is the banter they're having just like any other couple.
This is the banter goes there also.
So, because we're in that phase of the show now, the guys at Travelxp have given me something because they also want to get to know you a little more now. Like, what is behind...
For the next trip. Let's do this.
So, I'm going to throw a bunch of questions. These are basically questions about who is more likely to, right? Okay. But you don't have time to answer. So you can either point towards yourself or point at each other. Okay. It's very simple.
Sure.
Okay, first question. The game is very simple. Who is more likely to change the itinerary last minute? Who is more likely to click pictures of everything while traveling?
And me too, kind of.
Yeah, but...
But he's our memory keeper. I love it that he takes pictures all the time. Yes.
Who is more likely to fall asleep while traveling?
Neither of us.
Neither?
No.
Okay. Who is more likely to make friends with locals or start a conversation with a stranger? I can never do this.
I love talking to people.
How?
Everybody. I just like...
She went to America to a nightclub and there was this American boy. She sang the national anthem with him.
Because he was so excited. And then he knew the anthem. Yeah.
Who is more likely to turn a 5-minute stop into a 2-hour exploration?
That would be me.
Who is more likely to attempt speaking the local language but completely butcher it?
No. I won't butcher it.
But you will butcher it. If you don't know the language, how do you speak it?
No, I won't speak it unless I know.
Do you have an experience you'd want to share?
But I can share an experience. Don't criticize her because you'll never get an answer. I will not speak like that. I'll speak properly.
I won't speak if I don't know how to speak it.
I'm giving you tips not for travel, for marriage.
This is quite an informative podcast. So, who is more likely to ask a million questions during a guided tour?
Because, but I have to give it to her. All those questions translate into our next experience, and which now I've learned to appreciate.
Thank you.
All those times where she's taken us and put that damn thing on and said, "Acha, ye dekho, ye dekho, ye dekho." Now I realize that it's actually made a difference to my daughter. She's got interested in art and history. She's going to be majoring in art history.
Passionate traveler, unbelievable husband.
Unbelievable.
Who is more likely to overspend on luxury souvenirs?
No, luxury items. Souvenirs.
Okay.
No?
Items, huh?
Luxury
and souvenirs
items.
Also. Like I would go the first time I see a souvenir, I want to buy it, and she'll say, "Dekh to lo aspas." I said, "Kitne ka hoga?"
Who is more likely to ask for directions and then still get lost?
Come on, do I need to point?
Me? No, I'm Google.
Yeah, you are Google. Yeah. You know, Google takes you to the middle of nowhere sometimes. So you have arrived at your destination.
We've had the best experience with Google. We were in Italy, in Tuscany, and suddenly, we come into literally in a small town in the middle of nowhere, and it says, "You have reached your destination."
In the middle of nowhere. You can't
see us. And we're like, "Hello, yeah. Google auntie, where have you got us?" Because Google had just started at that
time.
So
Google also makes mistakes.
Yeah, Google can make a mistake sometimes, yes.
Last question. Who is more likely to dramatically overpack for the trip and still complain?
Come on. Itna time nahi hai. Fatafat bole.
See, yeah. It's me only, but I knew you were going to point to me. So I was like, yeah, it's me.
Who packs faster?
Him.
And do you like take conscious decisions like all couples do in terms of what your outfits are going to look like and stuff like
that? No, only when we are shooting.
Yeah, otherwise, because we are actors.
So the difference is, you know, they need a lot of changes and they need accessories. Like men have black t-shirt and black jeans.
The best.
I just, yeah. And when I'm traveling, I like to travel light. You know, like right now we were having a discussion in the car. I'm leaving for America in 3 days. She said, "You have to take 2 bags. I said, "For 7 days, I'll take 2 bags. I will not. So it's cold there, but I'll take my jackets and I won't take too many."
Yeah.
So finally, now that we're at the end of this, anything for people who would want to go to AlUla, any word of advice for them, anything that you'd like to tell them?
I would like to just say one thing to them. Just go.
I would say, second that. Because we cannot describe in words what that place is and how beautiful it is. It's something that you have to experience. And I know people say that about a lot of places they've gone to, but I can say this on record. There is no other place like AlUla.
AlUla was surreal.
Yeah, surreal.
It was a beautiful, magical place in the middle of the desert. The food, the culture,
you just
everything,
have to go
everything, and all these experiences.
As a foodie, do you remember the dishes? Because I like to keep note of this.
I ate everything. But of course, also let me tell people that all these hotels have cuisine from all over the world.
Oh, yeah.
So you're not going to be, you know, worried if you're traveling.
Any souvenirs that you brought back? I thought you'd get us some souvenirs.
Yeah, we got souvenir.
We always have
for
this
us?
One thing.
Oh, for you. Huh. I didn't know you though. I would have bought it for you.
I forgot to tell them the dates. The dates in AlUla, they have some... How many varieties of dates? Like some huge amount of different kinds of dates. So we got lots of dates from AlUla.
So before we finally wrap up, one final question. Hmm. You know, we have two shows right now for you on the Maharaja Express and the one in AlUla. Which one was the better experience?
I won't pick.
Yeah, can't.
I can't pick. They're two such diverse experiences, so poles apart that you can't pick either of them. They were both right up there. And there's no comparison.
The only thing that's common between the two, I would say, is both were luxury.
Super
luxe. Uber luxury, super. Luxurious experiences.
Yeah. Can you give us a teaser on where the next show would be?
Mm.
Or do you want to leave it at
you
that
know,
cliffhanger?
I'll tell you what, we would love to tell you. We're itching to tell somebody, but we can't. Because I know some things that they have.
Is it mind-blowing?
It's mind-blowing. Yeah. It has to be always. Better than AlUla. So they have to match that.
So Mr. and Mrs. Roy are going to be off on another adventure where we can't tell you. But wait for it.
But I think that was amazing. Thank you so much.
This
was great. Thank you very, very much. This was amazing.
So just talking about AlUla was so much fun for us. Imagine that.
It's amazing. I love it. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.